Hello everyone, here we are again with an explainer video. This time we will discuss what is inside a computer, what its components are, and what role each has. First of all, we have the computer case, which houses all its components. Let's take a look under the hood to see what we find. The motherboard is, as the name implies, the main board of a computer. Its role is to connect all the hardware to communicate with each other. All components of a computer are connected to the system board, processor, RAM, video card, hard disk connectors, or connections to USB ports. The central processing unit, CPU, or in short, the processor, is the brain of a computer. It connects directly to the motherboard and thus communicates with all other components. The main role of the processor is to execute commands. That is, any action performed by the user on a computer is transmitted as a command to the processor. Also, while operating, the processor will heat up more or less depending on the task performed. So, it will need a cooler to cool the processor. This cooler can be stock, usually a cooler consisting of a fan and radiator, or a cooler with liquid cooling. The graphics processing unit, or simply the video card, is the component responsible for playing back images on the monitor and the main component for playing video games. There are two types of graphics cards, integrated and dedicated. The integrated ones are integrated in a processor and share the processor's memory, which makes them less efficient. Instead, the dedicated one is connected to the motherboard via a PCI Express slot and sends the information to the monitor via an HDMI, VGA, DVI, or DisplayPort connector. Usually, if the image processing requirements are high, the video card needs cooling, which is done with the help of its fans. Random access memory is the computer's short-term memory. It temporarily stores data about frequently performed programs or processes. It should be noted that it is a volatile memory, i.e., it is erased every time the computer is restarted. Also, the more RAM you have, the more tasks your computer can perform at one time. To permanently store information in the computer, we need another type of memory called a hard disk drive, HDD, SSHD or SSD solid-state drive. The HDD consists of a disk that is read by a mechanical arm, while the SSD has flash memory and is much faster than the HDD. SSHD is also a hybrid storage unit, a combination of SSD and HDD. Virtually all files such as pictures, games, programs, etc. are stored on a hard disk or SSD. The larger the capacity of a hard disk or SSD, the more files we can store on our computer. These are connected to the motherboard via SATA ports or M.2 ports available for SSDs only. These types of memory have the task of storing various information in the computer so that it can be reused even after the computer is physically shut down. Another very important component is the power supply. It is located inside the computer case and provides direct current to all computer components. The capacity of the source must be chosen according to the consumption of all components. These are all the basic components that we find inside a computer and help it to function properly. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and share this video. See you in the next video.